The Kichuna Best Irrigation Scheme has enhanced the lives of farmers from 11 villages by increasing agricultural productivity throughout the year. Now farmers can benefit from their agricultural production, as Engineer David Mosige, the chairperson of Modo Farmers in the Rengaju Modo sub-county, explains.
When apples, I earn 15,000 shillings a day. I go to evening milk. If I'm lucky and I get 20 liters for selling, evening milk, that is an average of 30,000.
Excellency the President, that the following interventions have been made. One is providing the sub-county with water for production. This was a project undertaken by the Minister of Water and Environment. It is a 27 billion project, with water being tapped from Mount Rwenzori through a distance of over 35 kilometers to Rwenzori Motor Village.
Engineer Mwesige adds that apart from the irrigation project, the government has also given them 140 heifers, 500 pigs, poultry, cold rooms, and milk coolers, among others.
He did not, the president did not stop at only giving us water. There's a time where General Salim Saleh came to this village and he asked us, yes, you have had water. What is the problem in Rwenzori? He told them about six problems which he needed to solve. And they gave Rwenzori 140 heifers, fresh and heifers. They gave Rwenzori 500 pigs, young ones. They gave Rwenzori other things, like poultry.
Interventions and Operation Wealth Creation, championed by General Salim Saleh, under the accredited component, the people of Rwenzori have been able to receive a milk cooler, which is at the sub-county headquarters. We have been able to receive cold rooms where we can do bulking and we can store our produce.
However, some farmers who are not connected to the water scheme from 9 villages are still facing the challenges of drought.
Is the water. You've heard that Rwenzori Modo sub-county got a water irrigation scheme. And I happened to be one of the members who worked tirelessly to see that that water was delivered to Rwenzori. But unfortunately, in our area, this village, and other than about 9 villages, we never got that water.
The National Agricultural Advisory Services give farmers at Kidumbuli village a milk cooler of 2,000 litres, but it is not put to use due to lack of electricity to run it, among other challenges.
The cooler is, there is no electricity. So we are using a generator, cooling 200 litres of milk a day using a generator. The diesel you are using may be more expensive than the milk you are cooling.
Although the government launched the irrigation scheme for the farmers in Rwenzori, the Kabarole District LC5 Richard Rabuhinga says it has failed to fulfill most of the pledges to the farmers.
We promised greenhouses to this area as a motto. Just 500 goats, which have not received yet. Like I said earlier, the roads, the electricity, the water are not yet up to 100%.
Now farmers have started a cooperative union which will help them market their produce, reduce costs and quality of input used, as engineer David Mosige, the chairperson of Modo Farmers in Rwenzori Modo sub-county, explains.
Looking at bulk purchasing, we have a group of onion growers here. We intend to plant 15 acres of onions, but not on one garden. Each of the members plant his own between quarter and half acre, but in all we have 15 acres. Now the 15 acres of onions, we do bulk purchasing for the inputs. Seedlings, instead of buying your own seedling, one tin is 60,000, 50,000. But when you go to the manufacturer and buy bulk in boxes, you find you are buying a tin at 30,000.
The then Rengaju village, now a sub-county, has declared a Modo in 2006 by President Museveni during his usual visit of mobilizing the country to increase production and enhancement of household income under the theme of tapping wealth. Rengaju sub-county consists of 3,000 households, and of these, only 80 are registered Modo farmers, compiled by Doreen Nasima for the news.